welcome Hugh Laurie.
Thank you. It's very, very, very exciting to be here. What are you looking at? What are you looking at? It's very exciting to be here. Very, very wonderful to see so many people who just happen to be walking by on a Friday morning. It's very gratifying, and I'm particularly honored to be part of this official installation of Emma Thompson into the celestial firmament of stars. Or pavement. I have known Emma Thompson for more than half my life, which oddly enough is also more than half her life. I won't tell you how long that is, but Dire Straits had just entered the charts with Sultans of Swing. I don't know if you remember that. Well,
I remember that.
Well, I remember that. I know that it's... in fact, I should actually, you know, you're not embarrassed by me saying this, we actually stepped out briefly together as teenagers. Until she dumped me for a mime artist. I'm going to say that again. She dumped me for a mime artist. No matter. We embarked on a career doing this, working together on stage and film. And television, and I know it's customary in a situation like this to say that we couldn't, as wild-eyed ingenue, we could not possibly have imagined that one day we'd be standing on Hollywood Boulevard. Except that isn't true. I could have imagined it, and did, as did everyone else who saw Emma perform back then. She was the most obnoxiously talented person, and still is, that I've ever come across. Everything she did just oozed talent. She said talented things, she wore talented clothes, she rode a talented bicycle, she made talented spaghetti. It was really, really irritating. And there seemed to me to be a kind of inevitability, perhaps too strong a word, one can't be presumptuous, where any of us can be hit by a bus at any time, but there seemed to be foretold to those of us who knew Emma back then. And it is a huge, huge honor now to be standing here all these many, many years later, watching her take her rightful place. Although I should add that if ever there was an actress less fitted to be walked on, it's Emma Thompson. I just point that out for what it's worth. And I would add one more thing, and it's actually more to do with Emma's writing than her acting. Her acting is pretty plain for all to see. But the writing, I know of no other writer who writes for an entire ensemble of characters the way Emma does. And I don't just mean she gives a couple of good lines to the taxi driver, and it's much more profound than that. It reflects the view that Emma has of the world and of people, that everyone she meets and everyone she conjures up in her own imagination has a real life, and their life has a real meaning. And there is great humanity to the way she can invest meaning in an entire cast of characters in a movie and an entire group of people that she knows. I completely echo everything Maggie said, Maggie's experience about presence and remembering names and birthdays. By the way, she knows all your names. Now, I can guarantee you can all expect something on your birthday. You can expect a little tissue package. She is a truly remarkable person, a very good friend, and I could not be prouder.